Mission San Juan Bautista. It's the 15th mission in the mission system, founded in 1797, located right outside of Goa in central California. Let's go see the mission. Here at Mission San Juan Bautista, they have a museum so visitors can learn about the mission. Let's go in. Most of the mission was made by adobe bricks. Here's a form for adobe bricks, and here are some adobe bricks that have been revealed in the wall. A lot of the converted natives ate corn. They made it and ground it up with this large grinding stone. They also used a smaller version. A lot of people at the time when the mission was in use were a lot smaller because they didn't have enough nutrition as we do today, which means they grew a lot smaller. Most adults have a lot of trouble getting through this door. A lot of the furnishings here are very old. This cover dates back to all the way to 1812, when it was built into the wall. This niche in the wall was built for statues of saints and for holy water. Let's go into the next room. The San Juan Bautista Mission Museum houses a large number of books in the Padre's library and living room. They have hymnals, they have Bibles, and they have a lot of other things too. They also have a Padre's reading desk. Padre is also known as a priest or a father. They even have one huge hymnal. They also have some unusual things in this museum. Very odd pit here. It seems that a bomb's under it. And look, there's money, isn't it? Maybe it's a money pit. This is the Padre's dining room. I have dug up a lot of tools and silverware and plates and other things that the Padres used to eat. They also have a large number of gardening tools. This is the industry room. Here, they made a lot of things for their mission's own use, and also to trade with. There are some candles that are being made, and here's a huge pot used for tanning animal skins to make shoes with. There are also some other cool things here. Here's spades and hoes, nails, horseshoes, and branding irons. Over there, there are some more branding irons too. Here, they have some more nails and saws and other tools. This is a woodworking bench and a huge wagon wheel. At the mission, they have a lot of vestments that the Padres used to wear that were made by the nuns or sisters. Different colors are for different occasions. This is the music room. They have a bass, an organ, a violin, hymn books, and other musical tools. Let's go out and see the garden. After seeing the museum, we want to visit the church. Let's go inside. When you enter the church, you'll realize that there's a little nave where there's a bowl of holy water. There are also more near the entrances. Here we are inside the church. During masses, this large door was open. One of the first things you'll see when you enter this church is how wide it is. It is the widest mission. It is also the only mission with a church that has three aisles. You also see, when you come in, the baptismal font. Adobe bricks were made when people were drying them outside. Sometimes, when drying them outside, animals would walk across them. Here's an animal footprint in the adobe brick. There's another one over here. This is one of the side altars in the church. There are many more. There's where the choir would sing. Here we are in the San Juan Bautista Church. Since it's Holy Week, you can find a wreath with purple cloth and palm leaves. Let's go explore more of the church. This church was originally designed to hold over 1,000 people. This is the pulpit. This is where the priest or padre would usually deliver his main sermon. There are also many paintings and statues, as you can see. Here are some statues of saints. One in the lower middle is St. John the Baptist. San Juan Bautista is Spanish for St. John the Baptist. Latin was the main language of the church. You'll see many examples of it everywhere. I bet you've noticed the paintings by now. They were all done by a sailor from Boston. They're up on the ceilings, they're on the arches, they're on the walls. Here you can see some more of the decorative paintings of this church. Here are some stairs up to the pulpit, which we talked about earlier. On the ceiling, you can see the ancient board which holds this whole mission together. The mission was built as a square. The church is one side of the square. In the middle of the square were the gardens. Let's go outside. Are you coming? Here are one of the original bells of the mission. It even says San Juan Bautista on it. Here are all the missions in order, starting from first, then to last. in the garden. They have many roses, flowers, other plants, trees, and this huge cactus. Now we're going to visit the oldest part of the mission, the chapel. It's called the Chapel of Guadalupe. Let's go inside. Welcome to the Chapel of Guadalupe. This is where the European and Mexican friars held their mass and other ceremonies. It was constructed starting in 1799 and ending in 1803. There's a confessional over there. There are chandeliers and other paintings, candles, and rugs. Here is the cemetery. Over 4,000 Native American converts and missionaries were buried here. Here we are in front of the Mission San Juan Bautista. On your right is the bell wall and the gate to the cemetery. On your left is the area where the friars used to live. San Juan Bautista Mission is the only remaining mission that still has a plaza. Over there is the Plaza Hotel and the stables. There are many industries at the mission. One of them is making tallow. Tallow is made from melting cow fat. The mission bought these from whaling ships. These are hides that the mission sold to tanners to make shoes with. Here is an adobe brick bakery. Now I'm going to show you how to make flour. The people at the mission would have mules, cows, or horses, or some other form of animal pushing these around. This whole thing would rotate, making this rock turn around. There would be grain right here. Since the two rocks would be pushing against each other, little wheat grains would come out here, creating flour. The flour would be used at the bakery, made out of adobe bricks.
we are on the San Andreas Fault, the site of many earthquakes. The mission's had to rebuild itself twice because of it. The San Andreas Fault bleeds down to a huge array of farmland, making the mission very attractive. Thank you for visiting the Mission San Juan Bautista with me. I hope you can come visit it yourself sometime.
Let's go see the mission.
Wait, no, I don't know.
This niche in the wall was built for statues of saints. Let's go out to the cemetery. From sailors that cooked Vietnam. tides. That would be I messed up, I said tides.
Whale cows. Whale cows. Whale cows.
There are many industries at the mission. The mission bought this cauldron from some whaling owner. Restart.
The chickens are going to be in this shot. The chickens are going into the barbecue.
The mission was built on the San Andreas Fault. There were several volcanoes.